Most gadgets aren't meant for users to be opened. Imagine if Microsoft would just allow you to open up your Xbox and tinker with the insides because you just feel like it, especially if you don't know what the hell you're doing. What? But the Dygma Raise was designed differently. It was designed so that it could be taken apart by the customer. Hey there, Dygmates. I'm Dominique, Head of Communications here at Dygma. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to properly open your Dygma Raise keyboard and show you the insides of its majestic beauty. But before we open anything up, we need to get some expert advice. And who better to talk to than our product manager himself? Manel, it's been a while since your fans have seen you.
Yeah, I've been very, very busy manufacturing the Raise and other products. So yeah, I'm happy to be back.
Awesome, that's great. So let's get on with it. What consists of the body of the Raise?
This is the body of the Raise. This is the base of the top panel. And above the top panel, we have two colors, silver and black aluminum piece of 1.5 millimeters, and then stamp to get the shapes and all the holes and everything, and anodize. Apart from the anodizing, we have two different surface finishings. On the sides, it's like sandblasted, and all the top surface is brass. The base, this is a totally different piece. This is injection, double injection, and two different plastics. The first plastic is the ABS.
Oh, you mean acrylonitrile butadiene styrene?
Exactly.
258, right?
Exactly.
My favorite number.
And the other plastic is the polycarbonate. We have these small canals, it's like the light pipes.
Uh-huh.
And we receive all the light here from the PCB. And then the light, it has like a mirror, a 40 degree mirror on this side. So the light is coming this direction and then distributed only 160 degrees to the diffuser that is around. So it's all calculated so the light is even and has the same intensity in all the perimeter.
But this isn't what users see. What users see is this sticker, right?
Yeah, this is called the mylar.
Ah yes, the biaxially oriented polyethylene terephthalate.
Oh, impressive.
Yeah.
That's it.
Then we have my favorite component, the joint. Smoke weed every day. Yes, yes.
As the metal panel and the base are separate components, we have a metal piece to hide the gap between them.
So thanks, Manel, for all your time. Now, I don't want to keep you any longer, especially now since I'm going to dissect your beautiful pump pads.
Leave my pump up. Leave my
Bye, Manel. We also have the pump pads. The top layer is made of PU skin, synthetic leather. It has a bit of texture. It also has a matte finish. And the inside and the bottom material is a magic silicone that will never lose its stickiness. It's magic. Next are keycaps. We offer two different types of keycaps, PPT double injection and ABS laser etched. To remove the keycaps, make sure you use the Dygma keycap switch puller and then just start removing them. Now that we have our keycaps neatly laid out here, let's now proceed to our switches. Now to remove the switch, make sure you use again the keycap switch puller. You need to clip the bottom and the top part over here and just pull gently. How to remove the stabilizers. Our stabilizers are plate mounted, so you can easily remove them and dismount them if you like. To remove the stabilizers, there are these little hooks or clips that you just need to clip up. Actually, you can already remove them. Now, if you really want to disassemble them, you just need to remove this bar from plastic. And as you can see, you can just pull it out. And there are two plastic pieces. Be careful not to lose them. If you want to open the Raise, you should unscrew the screws at the back, not the ones at the front. They're actually for the metal pins. So, now, the moment we've all been waiting for. Let's open up our Dygma Raise, shall we? We start by unscrewing the screws at the back. Make sure that you push onto the screw and then turn, because if you don't do that, you might break the thread. That was easy. Just gently remove the metal panel from the base. There are two PCBs per side of the brace, one PCB for the low profile switches and one PCB for the main switches, and they're connected by this wire tape. And we would need to untoggle this little clip thing, toggle it down, and then pull the tape from the PCB. And here we have it. Low profile PCBs, main PCB. Why are the low profile PCBs and the main PCB different? Well, it's because the low profile switches are shorter and have a different dimension and actually have different pins compared to the normal switches. Now let's remove the other side. All right, here we have again the tape. Now to remove them, and then remove the wire tape. To remove the PCBs, there are actually four screws here on each side. By removing the PCBs, we just... Again, be careful doing this. You don't want to break the screws. Time to remove the PCBs. We have one. And we have two.
No, please, please.
The main PCBs and the low profile PCBs. To remove the low profile PCBs, you can also just unscrew them from the base. The main computer on each side is this microchip here, and its job is to read all the keys as quickly as it can and communicate with the LED driver, which is over here. And they're the ones who basically control all the LEDs on the keyboard. So for every key, we have these cool sockets. These allow you to hot swap your mechanical switches, and they're basically in charge of the electrical connection in your keyboard. And then we have the reverse mounted RGB LEDs for each key, and then these LEDs are for the underglow. But that's not all the PCBs we have. The final PCB is in the neuron. This bad boy. To open the neuron, first you need to remove the metal jacket, which is quite easy to remove. You just move it like that. If we go to the back of the neuron, it might help to remove the sticker. If you do remove the sticker, unfortunately, this will void your warranty. There are these clips that you can unhook the plastic part from. And voila! We have the PCB, the brain of your Dygma Raise, ladies and gentlemen. Here you can find an LED that kind of lights up the Dygma logo when you turn on your keyboard. And then at the back, we have the microchip. And here we have a reset button in case you want to reset your firmware or put it back to bootloader mode. The reason we have the microchip as a separate component from the keyboard is so that you can use one side of the keyboard and detach the other side. And we call this the anti-flame mode. We created this for all you tilt monkeys out there. Now let's talk about the cables. When you get a Dygma Raise keyboard, you get four cables. A USB-C to USB-A cable, which you connect the neuron to your computer. You get two USB-C to C cables that you connect each side to the neuron, and you also get an extra 50 centimeter USB-C to C cable in case you wanna spread your keyboard far apart. The USB-C to C cables are unique. We wanted them to have more flexibility, and in order to do that, we had to remove a couple of wires inside the cable. If we look inside the cables, you can see here that the USB-A to C cable has another type of shielding made of aluminum and an extra wire inside that makes it more rigid. And since the USB-C to C cable doesn't have that aluminum, it's more flexible. But it does have the essential wires to get the power from the neuron and transfer it to the keyboard. So if you plug these USB-C to C cables to your phone, it won't charge you. So that's it. We've completely dissected the Raise, opened it up, and took out all of its insides. I hope you liked this video and that you learned a thing or two. And if there's any particular topic that you want us to cover next, please write it down in the comments below. Now it's time for me to clean up this mess. Don't forget to like this video, or else.